reading time and again, just do that. Keep coming back to whatever notes that you have, man's notes, your own notes. Keep reading, there's no other way. Revising is all about reading again and again and again. As many times you can read, the better. And the other question was how to manage time, right? So my strategy was to basically finish our optionals 2 or 3 months before you give your prelims, at least once. Now, if you do it twice, nothing like it, but at least once, finish off optionals, the static part, because dynamic, I mean, in IR and all, things keep changing. Events will keep happening till 1 or 2 months before your mains, so that you'll have to keep yourself updated. But otherwise, generally, finish off the static portions and all that 2 or 3 months before prelims, and then last 2-3 months is focused on prelims. So when your prelims is it's on June 3rd, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, March 3rd would be
March.
Jan, this month, just fully focus on your options. Just focus on pol science. Pol science is going to be, and first of all, let me tell you that you've chosen a very good optional. And you've obviously chosen a very good teacher. Now, all political science will help you in terms of understanding concepts about India's polity in general. Now, this the tangible gain is you have GS2, where there's a lot of overlap. The other tangible gain is your ethics paper, your essay paper, and the other gain is again ethics, slightly lesser way, but ethics also. But yeah, essay and GS2, you have tangible gains. Intangible gains in terms of your understanding about Indian polity, world politics, international relations, all of that. This will help you in interview. Even when you get into the service, a lot of things that they teach you in the training, a lot of the, so imagine you go for your village visit, detachment or whatever, a lot of things that happen on the ground will have some bearing on the other, on things that you study over the course of these 5-6 months. So it's a great optional. So, and I think it's relatively fun studying the optional, especially beautiful notes. So yeah, can you call me Siddharth instead of Sir? So has anyone of you seen any of my infamous and notorious videos on YouTube? You've seen one. Okay, so largely people, so I can torture most of you again. So so the question in terms of current affairs, now the way I did it was, whenever a news, let me just give you a brief background. I had to write the exam twice. First time I did not clear. Not only did I not clear, my political science score was 186. My GS2 score was 63 or 64. So clearly, optional, which is supposed to be my strength, was where I messed up the most. So I knew that there was something wrong, and I had to sort of analyze where it went wrong. What I did was, when the mains, I was in Delhi, I was preparing in Delhi, and mains results came in February 2016. And I'm not qualified. I wanted to hang around in Delhi for some more time. I had run out of money also. And then my parents were like, no, it's okay, stay there, do some more classes if you want. I'm like, no, I'll come back home. So after reaching home, first two weeks, I didn't study anything. I just analyzed what went wrong. And clearly there was something, and I think those 2 weeks helped me crack the exam more than anything else that I ever did after that or before that. Those 2 weeks were very critical because I identified. One mistake that I could not rectify was I hardly attended classes here. Ma'am knows. I would come, walk in like once in 2 or 3 weeks, and then ma'am would see me and, oh, please come and sit. You are here. She used to be so happy to see me in class once in a while, and then she would, with her sense of humor, she used to poke a lot of fun at me, try to reform me through her sense of humor, which clearly did not work out. One mistake. So please, this was structure of legitimation, maybe structure of coercion is also needed to sort of, to rectify deviant behavior. So yeah, one genuine suggestion to all of you, these classes are like very important. Just I mean, she has not told me what to say or anything of that sort, but huh. So please try to attend classes and don't miss any of them. You will realize. So the one example I keep saying, telling people, so ma'am, I mean again, ma'am's sense of humor is something I can connect with very well. When she teaches this water disputes, she quotes Mark Twain when he says, you know, water is for drinking and whiskey is for fighting over. Sorry, whiskey is for drinking and water is for fighting over, sorry. Now, my essay had a question on water disputes, and this is the first thing I wrote. Whiskey is for drinking and water is for fighting over. And I didn't do too badly in my essay. So there are so many things that she does in the class, the way she, so one of the classes which I came for was Gramsci. I remember sitting in a class of Gramsci, and Gramsci is my favorite scholar. I mean, he's my favorite thinker. I wish I'd sat through the rest of the lectures, maybe all of them would have been favorites. So I sat in LS and realized that, you know, in terms of current affairs and all that, I was making a lot of notes which are pretty useless. And towards the end, I revised them. I mean, nothing was making sense. So, and yeah, by the way, when I wrote my first attempt, I did not even have a copy of the syllabus. I cleared main prelims, but then I did not even know what the syllabus looked like. And the first thing I did was I downloaded the syllabus and I said, okay, this is what it is. This exam is about. So anyone left to look at the syllabus in its totality, I'm sure there's someone. Oh my God. Okay. It's okay. Maybe some more training in GS4 might bring out the truths. So then I downloaded the syllabus and I'm like, oh shoot, now there's a lot to study now. This is the first thing I did. So in the 2 weeks, I kept reading the syllabus, like, you know, what's there and what's not there. And by two weeks, I got him, okay, these are things that are there. Now, when I read the newspaper, I try to connect the newspaper with topics in the syllabus. So when I see a news item, I know, okay, a question could be asked from this portion of GS3 or GS2 or whatever. And this is an exercise I used to do on a constant basis, daily. Now I see for example, when I saw this issue, so in 2000, I wrote 2016 mains. And 2016 was a time when there was a lot of fighting going on between Delhi government and the central government. And there used to be commentaries on a daily basis. And then editorials would come saying, why is why is Kejriwal right, or why is the Prime Minister right, etc., etc., etc. Now, I didn't read a lot of those articles, but I realized that this is an important question because it has a bearing on federalism. So the question came on cooperative federalism, why this thing happened. Now, I had made a list of such important topics, such hot issues which kept on coming. Now, what I did to add value to that was, I have a habit of connecting, my hobbies or whatever I do in my free time with the exam. So I used to watch, does anyone watch this show called Last Week Tonight by John Oliver? Okay, yeah. So it's a show that covers the important news events that happen during the course of a week in the United States. So in 2015, I had watched a show where he had covered Washington DC, how Washington DC is very different from other states in the United States. So when this Delhi dispute was happening, and this was 2015 December, now this is almost a year later, I had seen this video of Washington DC being different. I just thought very quickly, is this the same with other countries as well? I typed Canberra, and Canberra is Australian Capital Territory. It has its own special status, blah, blah, blah. Thank you. You can't skip IR at any point in your maybe the last 1 month of your prelims when you're too tied up with prelims, maybe that's the only time. Even then I would, even if I say that concentration, you will not be able to, I mean most of you will not be able to manage, that's the reality. I mean even now, by the way, now I have the experience of interacting with everyone right from rank 1 to rank 100 and sorry 1000 and whatever who's there with me in Masuri and all that. Let me tell you quite frankly that 1 month before prelims is very hard to study for mains. It's as simple as that. No one's done it. And rank 1 hasn't done it. I mean rank 1 too didn't do half of the stuff even I did. I mean, she was the most chilled out person. I mean if you, even in our academy she's like sleeping half the time in class and she's all chilled out. So don't think that people who crack this exam are, you know, very brainy and you know they've studied like 24 hours a day and all that stuff. That's not it. But yeah, how do I put this? Just what I would like to say is, don't. I mean, 1 month before the prelims is difficult, but otherwise, just keep at it. Keep reading two or three scholars that you think you relate to. You understand their language. You understand their thought flow, and then stick to them. But don't ignore them at any stage. Apart from probably that 1 month before prelims where you are going haywire. You know, you're like very concerned, history, geography, everything is on your mind, and probably that is the only time where you should not avoid. But otherwise, yeah, in terms of note making, what I used to do was I had separate notes for political science and separate notes for rest of GS. I used to read a lot of commentary. I chose political science not because I knew that political science would be a beneficial option in terms of GS2 or whatever. I chose political science because of my interest in the foreign service. I wanted to join the foreign service, that's why I wrote the exam. Now, it is because of that interest that I thought I'd get a background on international affairs and all that. That's the reason I took the particular option. Because of that, I loved reading these commentaries. I used to read, I used to make a lot of notes. The disadvantage there was my notes became very expensive and it became very difficult to revise. So what I'd suggest to you is ma'am has a certain list of scholars who she keeps quoting. Just, I mean, unless you really interested in this thing and you want to do it as a pastime or whatever, you can do what I did. But otherwise, just go with ma'am scholars. They are more than enough. And she keeps updating every day. I mean, today morning, if something is there in the newspaper, it comes in the evening notes. So that's the level of updation that you get from ma'am. So I would suggest stick to her scholars. If political science is just an exam that you want to crack to clear UPSC and that's your love for IR, then please stick to her scholars. But otherwise, you can do little extra note. Who wants to ask? Yeah. So stress and anxiety. One way, if I had come to class regularly, one way to handle stress and anxiety would have been to just look at her smile. I think she has the most wonderful smile in the whole world. I mean, I used to sit in class when she smiles. It used to remind me of my mom. So on a serious note, yeah, I had a support system. Like I had a couple of friends who were preparing me. Classes as big as this used to scare me a lot. And it still scares me. So I'm not a group person in terms of study. But I had one or two friends who I was in constant touch with on WhatsApp, and you know, to impress one of them, I took to photography. So where I stay in Cochin, the right behind me is a small marshy land, and there are a lot of creatures, everything from pythons to tortoises to everything. So I used to click pictures every day and share it with my friends. Then they would still say that no, you have to. You have a lot of work to do in photography and all that. So yeah. And I've never missed meeting a friend if he or she was in town. Have your set of relaxation. This exam is not the end of the world. Frankly, a bigger, better world is out there. So just take it easy. That's all. This is just an exam. This is not life. This is an exam. You have a life beyond this exam. So,
just give us a brief idea how you prepare GS1.
Just GS1, largely along with prelims, whatever the basic books. Again, I had listed down which source to study from for which topic. hidden that, then largely newspapers. Otherwise, you connect newspapers to this. And what I did slightly different in GS4 was, GS4 was the only paper you can actually study and expect something to come. Otherwise, the rest of it is very, very vast. And so GS4, what I did was, I had read ARC. From ARC, you get a lot of words like integrity, ethics, integrity, honesty, blah, 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 blah. So each and every single word I took, I found my own definition and I made my own example. So if a question on honesty comes, this is my definition, this is my example. I had it on at the top of my mind. So I can show you my notes. There are questions that came directly from my notes. For example, there was a difference between neutrality and impartiality. I had written it down, and I had written down the example. If a question had come, what is the difference between truthfulness and honesty? According to one definition, I don't know if this is the correct definition, but if the question had come, I would have written, honesty is a whole, is a much, being truthful is like, you know, is being very to the point and factual. It may not cover the whole stuff. So the one example that I would have written if this question had come was the example on how Dronacharya was killed. Yudhishthir had spoken the truth, but he was not being honest. Yeah, that was so I have made examples like this for every possible word in that ARC. And there aren't more than 25-30 words which you need to sort of mug up. And then I also went through the answers of all the, I used to take a lot of tests. And generally coaching centers upload best copies on their website. So I used to go through those, their papers, and I used to plagiarize shamelessly. This is not a research paper. I used to incorporate their ideas and I would make my own answers better. Yeah. Prelims. Prelims is a notion. I mean, there are certain set of books that you need to read them and then hope. Okay, one relevant thing I can suggest to you is, I had done my prelim studies well even in my first attempt. And I made some 200-300 pages of notes in art and culture and two questions came in my first attempt. This is how I managed to, even in political science, so my notes on the Indian constitution was some 544 pages. And zero was the number of questions that came. So I realized that I need to set my priorities right. And that's one thing that I did. I mean, what else? In terms of improving my score and all that, the exercise I did, I don't know if it worked or not, but I had taken some 30-35 test papers during my second attempt, because largely my basics were sorted even in the first attempt. Now I took some 30-35 tests, but after each test I would write down how many questions did I attempt, how many did I get right, among the questions I attempted, how many did I guess between two options, and what is my accuracy in that. Now, how many did I go for my gut feeling? Like, so three options and all, that level of detail I didn't have, but then I had these 4-5 columns. Then I would, I like color coding and stuff, so I put a formula in Excel. I mean, if it is more than 80% accuracy, it would come as green. If it is between 60 and 70, it would come as yellow. Then the rest of it would come as red. So I had this pictorial sort of representation. After 5 tests, I would see red, and I'm like, okay, there's something going wrong. So towards the end, I realized my gut feeling is a rut feeling. If it is left to my gut feeling, it is better not to answer. But guessing between two options, I knew that I was 60% or 60 or 65% or whatever. So if there was an option for me to guess between two options, I would just do it, because I knew that generally my accuracy tends to be right there. My gut feeling is bad, but guessing between apparently is better. So I had this sort of an information base before I went and wrote my prelims, and first time I scored 122 in prelims, where the cutoff was 107. I think last time it was 116. So my score was 147 or something, so which was an improvement over the margin that I had to play with last time. Because I played, but now I'll tell you what the irony is. So because I knew my gut feeling had a certain accuracy, there were 5 questions towards the end which my gut feeling said, okay, this is the answer, but then, you know, I'm an engineer, I've analyzed everything and all that, right? So I mean, the color codes tell me don't go for it. If I had gone for it, I would have got all 5 rights. So then my score would have been something like 157, and I mean, all anything above 116 was a waste of time. But otherwise, huh? But then this is the catch. So the, nothing is sort of absolute, but this is one thing that I get. Yeah. What did I do special related to? Nee, so one of the things that I did was to take this option. Like, so I would largely get a base of what. I listed down all the important issues of 1 year, then major. I mean, Israel Palestine. I mean. No, I mean, panelists, obviously I would have a prepared answer, but why would they ask that question? They would not. I mean, generally they see IFS as first option, they're like, oh, this guy knows. If I ask him, my IFS, he will tell me how he'll save India's foreign policy. I'm not going to ask him that question. So they didn't ask me anything on why I wanted to join the foreign service. But luckily, because my name is Siddharth, they went to Buddhism. And from Buddhism, they went into Afghanistan and Bambi Buddha and all that. Then I could, you know, sort of bring in my analysis. But so that way I got lucky, but otherwise they don't. They know. I mean, if you're this thing in IFS, they now okay. Lot of so our batch size is 39 as of now. I think one person is yet to join. Nine, which is right for one once, told me that it would be very important. So for prelims, I did go through several portals so that I don't miss even a single issue. This I did for prelims, but I don't know. Even if I had not done that, I would have scored. I mean, more or less scored. I would suggest. Take one, whichever coaching center, whichever material, just stick to one. For mains, so I relied heavily on one of the institutes. I used to get their material, and that the monthly current affairs summary is something that I used to read throughout. That was very helpful because I have a habit of stop. So once the prep gets a bit too intense, I stop reading the newspaper. I watch some news shows and I understand what's going on, but I stop reading newspapers. The only thing I would read is commentaries on international affairs. That I have my think tanks, I have my place to. I mean, I know where to look for. But yeah, I used to stop reading newspapers. That's there the coaching. See, I did Lakshmikant well. That was also required for your this thing, no? Prelims. I done that relatively well. There are stuff that are in GS2 which is not covered by the options, like governance issues and things like that. That too I did from ARC, whatever summary that I could find. But yeah. But otherwise, prep was largely optional centric. But then you have to switch your mindset. You can't write a GS answer like an optional answer. Don't quote scholars in GS. They'll be like, okay, who the hell is this guy? Is he like a cousin? I don't care. Like, so don't quote. The first attempt, I had written some scholars' names and all in my GS2. Please don't do that. Yeah.
Like you said that milestones.
I had everything. Like, technically speaking, the structure was there, milestones were there, a lot of things were there, but yeah. I missed a lot of milestones. I mean, in fact, I missed almost all my milestones, but I got there roughly. It's about here. I think everyone's, yeah.
Your strategy for essay?
Essay? Essay, please take a test series. I mean, ma'am, I had, so one thing which is lucky for me, I had taken her long distance that correspondence test series. And then as a jackpot, she said, you know, you take a test series in essay also, I'll evaluate and give you.
Right, okay, I don't have to spend money on another test series now. Then I wrote that test series and then first essay, why are you writing? You're not trying to use it. It's a random bullshit. Don't write like this. So I started and analyzed them. My third test series, wow. And then the important thing was, she was actually somehow just keeping track of my progress. That I didn't know how. Your essays have improved. And blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay. But yeah, but taking test series, so it's about the first half an hour you plan, you make a structure, then you write. I mean, think of some punchlines to begin with, punchlines to end with, you know. And so I had these two or three exams. I mean, again from Mahabharata, I had these two or three exams. Maybe I think some environment, and just like that, blah, blah, blah. I would just use it, but in terms of continuity, you can also do that also. What is it? Because I like international relations, I also have an interest in geopolitics. So I know where the countries are, where the seas are, where the states are, all of that. So, look at the map, from time to time. And by the way, they're not going to ask you random questions. Generally, if there's a crisis in Syria, they may ask something near Syria. I have not drawn a single diagram in any of my articles. So I study teaching them more and especially draw maps and teaching. Yeah. History is something I love. So I have read all the NCRTs from, I don't know, any of the whatever they are answering. I had underlined, but history is something that you can do, like me, if you want to, you like to see that, again, respect the time that you have. You don't have to do all that, just read that Modern India, the small book. The small book, not that you can text them, that's like God's gift. Just read that, and that will cover most of it. And our server is good because it covers a lot of culture and stuff like that. You can skip medieval if you want. That's your job.
Last year it was not a test. Last year the people, even maps were people like
last 15 years, the entire world. Now, how realistic is that? So I wrote this, like, you know, all good, we have nice commitments, but just let's see. These are the kind of points that I wrote, but yeah. Like I said, this only happens because I have a habit of connecting something that happened 2 years back to what I'm wearing or some random comedy video I'm watching. So that sort of helped me. I told you I had made a 500-600 page notes on Constitution. I'm trying to learn the 9th schedule, and I went, there was this video by present Chief Justice Rohinder Nariman. He was a lawyer back then. He had delivered a lecture on the 9th schedule. How the 9th schedule came into being, and what is its importance, what is the historical context, blah blah blah. The question on an I.R. Koilu case. So he starts on the I.R. Koilu case. Why is I.R. Koilu important? What did the Supreme Court do? What should the Supreme Court have done? Etc. etc. Then 2 years down the line, I.R. Koilu. So it's called luck. By the way, everything is, if you're lucky, you'll crack. Otherwise, even if you study better than the rank one, you will not crack. So that humility, I think all of you should have. Even if you study very, very well, you may not crack this exam. And this exam is not the end of the world. There's much better things to do in life than studying for an exam or joining the civil service. So good luck, everyone. Enjoy your time here. We will keep you entertained and informed at the same time.